Very good morning, dear students. This video is for class 10th, subject science, chapter number 13, magnetic effects of current. And this is lecture number 1. In our previous lectures, we have finished our chapter number 12, that is electricity. And today, in this lecture, we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 13, magnetic effects of current. So let us see the content of the lecture. So in this lecture, first, we will see the overview of chapter number 13. That we will see how we are going to proceed in chapter number 13. Then we will start with our first topic, that is introduction to magnets. Then we will cover up the electromagnetism. And further in the lecture, we will study magnetic field and magnetic field lines. And the end, we will see the homework and homework solutions of the pre-text assignment that we have given you in the previous lectures. Or we can discuss that solution in another video, but let us begin with the overview of chapter number 13. Chapter number 13 is having many topics, and the first topic of the chapter is magnetic field and magnetic field line that we are going to cover in our lecture number 1. That is the same lecture we are in. Then the next topic will be magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor, or we can say the magnetic field due to a current through a straight conductor. And also the right hand thumb rule, which is used to find out the direction of the magnetic field generated around a conductor. So that we'll cover up in the second lecture. Then in the third lecture, we will do magnetic field due to a current through a circular loop and magnetic field due to a current in a solenoid. That we'll cover up in the lecture number 30. In lecture number 4, we will do the force on a current carrying conductor in magnetic field and the working of electric motor. So this is lecture number 4. In lecture number 5, we will study electromagnetic induction and the working of electric generator. In lecture number 6, we will study about the domestic electric circuits. So this is how we are going to take our lectures. So let us begin with the first topic, that is magnets. We all know what magnets are. So we can say about the magnet that magnet is a substance that attracts small pieces of iron. It points in north and south direction when it is suspended freely. It has two poles, north and south. It is made up of magnetite, which is an ore of iron, and this is Fe3O4. This is dark blackish brown in color, and that is why it is also called black stone or lodestone. Magnets can be natural or artificial. The first type of magnet is a bar magnet, which is the simplest one. That is a substance with magnetic effects or magnetic properties in the shape of a bar is called a bar magnet. It is having two poles, north and south. So when we have done it many a times in our childhood, that when we bring a bar magnet near another bar magnet, that sometimes the poles get repelled by each other, but sometimes they get attracted. So why it is so? It is because that the bar magnet that we have is having two poles, north pole and south pole, and when we bring two bar magnets together, we want to bring them together, then what happens if we are bringing together the same poles, whether it is north north of two bar magnets or south south poles of the two bar magnets? So they will always repel each other and they will force the other magnet to move away from it. So this shows that like poles always repel each other. The next thing is that when we bring two different poles like north towards south or south towards north, So there is a force of attraction. They move towards each other. This is shown by the arrows here. One important property of a bar magnet is that when we suspend a bar magnet by tying it up in the middle and when we suspend it freely in the stand like this, so it always points in the north south direction of the earth. Why is it so? It is because that the earth is also a giant magnet. Why? Because in its core there is iron, and because of the presence of that iron, it behaves as a magnetic or you can say it is showing magnetic properties. But this effect is very weak, and that is why we do not feel the magnetic effect of earth. But we know that earth is having north, south, east and west geographical directions. But the inside the earth, the iron is, it is circulated, or you can say that it is distributed in such a way that the north and south of the magnetic bar that is formed here inside the earth is somewhat deflected from the north south of the earth. And what we have, that at a tilted position we have S and N pole of the magnet which is there inside the earth. So geographical north and magnetic south pole, they are together. The same happens as this is showing the magnetic properties. This is also a bar magnet. So we have studied that same poles, they repel each other, and different poles, they attract each other. Here we have seen it. So when we suspend a bar magnet freely by tying it up with a thread in a stand, then it always trying to align itself in the field of earth's magnetic field. So the north pole of the bar magnet, or you can say earlier we were not knowing the names of the bar magnet poles, but we have named them so that the pole end which is pointing in the direction, or you can say the geographical north of the earth, is north pole of the magnet, and which is pointing towards the south of the geographical south of the earth is the south pole of the magnet. So it is south seeking, because this will get attracted towards the north of the magnetic north of the earth. So this is how magnetic properties of earth, they cause any bar magnet to suspend in the direction of north and south of the earth directions only. There are many other types of magnets as well, like horseshoe magnet, some electromagnets are there, but we use generally a magnetic compass in the navigations. By the sailors it is used widely. So what is a magnetic compass? Actually, a magnetic compass is a small magnetic needle, or you can say it is a pointer, pivoted at the center and in a small aluminium or brass case it is present with a glass top. So it is a small pointer which is having a nail at the center so that it can rotate on a horizontal plane, and it always points in the north-south direction of the earth. Why is it so? That how it gets deflected? It gets deflected to point the north-south direction of the earth, because we know that earth is having. So let us understand that why a magnetic compass needle gets deflected when it is placed in any magnetic field. So we know that earth is having a magnetic field. as it is behaving as a magnetic material. So it is having its geographical north and south, and accordingly it is having its magnetic axis as well. So here it is having south pole and here it is having north pole of the magnetic axis of the earth. So what happens when we place a magnetic needle in the magnetic field of earth, which is very weak? This is north pole, so this will get attracted towards the south pole of the magnetic field or magnet which is there in the earth. So this will get attracted towards south, and this south pole will repel this south pole, because earth is very large, so it will be placed somewhere around here. So the north pole will go or will get attracted towards the south pole, but this south pole will get repelled by the south pole. As we know that like charges or like poles of the magnet, they repel each other, but unlike poles they get attracted. So you can see here that here we have a situation where a force is here in upward direction and here in downward direction, but as the magnetic needle is deflected because of the same amount of force but in different directions. So this kind of force generates a torque, and because of that torque that needle gets deflected, and this needle comes here and this south comes here. So that's how a magnetic compass helps us to find out the north, which is geographical north I'm talking about. It will indicate the geographical north and south only. So this is the torque which is generated here because of the magnetic field of any material or any space, because of which the magnetic needle gets deflected, and hence it helps us to navigate. So as in today's chapter number 13, we have to study about the magnetic effects of current. Earlier we have seen many kinds of effects because of the current. We have seen heating effects produced because of the current. Like when current flows in a conductor, it produces heat because of the resistance of the material. And so that was the heating effect of current. We have also seen the chemical effect of current. How? That in the chemistry chapters we have discussed about the process electrolysis. In electrolysis process, what happens? We pass electricity through a solution, and that solution or the particles of the solution, the constituents, they get decomposed and they form simple products. Like we have electrolysis of water. So when we pass electricity through the water, what happens? It should be a balanced equation. So we get hydrogen and oxygen molecules. Many a times they are in the form of ions. So this is what happens in case of electrolysis. So we have seen that here one chemical reaction is getting performed because of the current. So that is chemical effect of current. But today we have to study about the magnetic effect produced because of the current. So there must be a question in your mind that how magnetic effect is generated because of the current, or how current can produce magnetic effect or magnetism. It's okay, we are here to answer you. So let us discuss this thing in detail. So let us see how current helps in production of magnetism. So magnetism was already known before from the ancient times. And electricity, that is current, was discovered in 17th century. Then after the discovery of current, it took so long that for the scientists that they observed the relation between the electricity and magnetism. What happened? In 1819, Oersted, who was a Danish scientist, He experimentally found that when in an electric circuit, current is passed through it and a magnetic needle is placed near it, then the magnetic needle gets deflected. But we have studied that magnetic needle of the magnetic compass deflects only when there is a magnetic field near it. So he did the experiment that when no current was flowing, no deflection was there in the magnetic needle. But when he passed the current and he saw that there is a deflection in the magnetic needle, then he reversed the direction of the current once. So earlier, when the current was flowing from A to B in this direction, the magnetic needle was pointing towards the west. After reversing the direction of the current in the electric circuit, now current is flowing from B to A. And now the deflection of the magnetic needle gets changed. It is now deflecting in another direction. So this experiment confirmed that yes, for sure there is a magnetic field around this conductor, around this wire, because of which this needle gets deflected. So this was done by Oersted and he proved it with the experiments. So he concluded that yes, moving charges, because current is what? It is a flow of charge only. So moving charges produce a magnetic field around it. So we have seen that the moving charges, they produce a magnetic field around them. But this was what he concluded. But what is the reason behind it? So let me explain you that every material, every substance is made up of atoms. We know atom is the fundamental unit of the any substance. So if the pink circles here are representing the atoms or the arrangement of the atom in any substance, then if we talk about a single atom, that how is it behaving in the metal, in the material itself? So we can take it as that, let us have an enlarged view of atom. What is there in the atom? One nucleus and the electrons rotating, revolving around it. So here we observe that electrons which are revolving around the nucleus, they are orbiting or they are revolving in different domains. Or let's not talk about the domains because it will create some higher level study. So it's okay. Let it be at our level. So let it be simple. So what do we have here? One electron revolving in the orbit around the nucleus and one nucleus. So there are types of motion happening in the nucleus and in the electron. And what is that? If we talk about the electron, which is revolving around the nucleus. So we know electron is having two types of motion in it. One is revolution around the nucleus and another rotation on its own axis because of its spin. That means two motions are there in electron. Then the nucleus also rotating about its own axis. So we are having three types of motions in nucleus and electron. But we have studied that whenever a charge moves, it causes the production of current. That is, flow of charge is always what? Current. So that means nucleus, that the motion of the nucleus, or you can say the rotation of the nucleus around its own axis and the rotation of electron around their axis, as well as revolution of electron around the nucleus. They constitute a small amount of current. Why? Because here we have a flow of charge. Charge is flowing. That means a current is there. So there is a small amount of current in every atom because of the motions of nucleus and electron. So this current can be shown as that this current, which is very small in amount, is when we talk about the nucleus, then the nucleus is rotating on its own axis. So that is also in circular motion. When electron revolves around the nucleus, that is also a circular motion of charge. And when electron revolves around its own axis, even then it is a circular motion of the charge. That means there is a current which is flowing in the circular motion. And we have studied that whenever current flows in a circular loop, it always produces a magnetic moment. So that means nucleus, which is having a small amount of current in a circular motion, that will produce one magnetic moment in a particular direction. Then electron will produce two magnetic moments, one because of the rotation on its own axis and because of the revolution around the nucleus. So that's why we get three magnetic moments for nucleus, for electron in its own axis, and for electron revolution around the nucleus. And because of the three magnetic moments, which are pointing in different directions, when we bring a resultant magnetic moment, so that is here in this direction, that will point in a particular direction. So this is now the magnetic moment of the whole atom. So this is our atom, and now this is its magnetic moment. So we have seen that there are some materials which are naturally magnetic, but some they behave as a magnet when magnetic field is provided to them. So the materials in which all the atoms are having a net magnetic moment in a single direction, or the magnetic moments of all the atoms are aligned in a particular direction, then that material behaves as a natural magnet, or it's a permanent magnet. Then there can be some materials which having the atoms with the magnetic moments, the final magnetic moment of each atom is pointing in random direction like this. So this is not a magnet. Even if I talk about the iron, which is the most important substance when we talk about the metals, magnets. So when we touch two iron pieces, they do not attract each other because they are not having magnetic property, although they have this kind of arrangement. So this is the arrangement of the magnetic moments in different directions. That means here domains, simple and small domains, are formed with a net magnetic moment. So many number of magnetic moment domains are here, and when we apply a magnetic field, remember, then all the random magnetic moments of the atoms, they're trying to align them in one direction or in the direction of the magnetic field. And in that case, this substance will behave as a magnet. And it will behave as a magnet till this magnetic field is passed through it. So now we can conclude that yes, moving charges can produce magnetic effect. This is what Oersted discovered. So that's why he is right. And he discovered that moving charges can produce a magnetic effect. So now you can understand the meaning of the word electromagnetism. When magnetism or magnetic effect is produced because of the electric current, it is called electromagnetism. This process can also be reversed. And this was done by Faraday, who concluded that when current can produce magnetic effect, then vice versa can also be true. That with the help of magnetic effects, we can also generate electricity. So this relation between the current and magnetism or magnets with each other is called electromagnetism. Now let us study about the magnetic field. So when we talk about the magnetic field, how can we explain it? As we have talked about the magnets, like bar magnets, that when the same poles of bar magnet, they are brought near to each other, then there is a force of repulsion. We have not brought the poles in direct contact, but still they are repelling each other. And when we bring the opposite poles of the magnet towards each other, then they attract each other even without direct contact. So why is it happening? So it can be assumed that yes, for sure, there is some kind of field, there is some kind of force here in between the magnet poles which is causing it this repulsion and attraction between the like poles and unlike poles respectively. So it was concluded that the magnetic field, we can define magnetic field as the region or the space around the magnet where its influence, whose influence? Magnet or magnetism, magnetic property that can be felt by other substances. So that is called magnetic field. That space or region is called magnetic field. So if it is kind of a region which is having its influence on other materials, then how can we visualize the magnetic field? So for that we have to perform an activity. And what is that? There are two methods to do it. The first is magnetic compass always deflects in the north-south direction of the magnetic field. So that means magnetic compass, it responds to the magnetic field. So if there is a magnetic field around a bar magnet, then it magnetic compass will also respond to the magnetic field of the bar magnet. So when we place the magnetic compass, which is having north and south directions, and when we place it near the north, what will happen? Because the direction of the magnetic compass is this, that this top arrow is indicating the north direction and this end is indicating south direction. So when we bring the north pole of the magnet near the magnetic compass, it will, if magnet is here, then it will go away from it. So the same thing is happening, that it will, the north will get deflected away from the north pole. And when we place the magnetic compass on different places, then we can draw the path of the north pole, that how it will move if it is free. So we got that the magnetic compass is indicating in these directions, and it shows that the magnetic effect is somewhere ending up here. Then if we draw a line by making or by joining these points, then we get a line, and this line is nothing but the representation of the path that North Pole will follow if it is kept free in the magnetic field of this magnet. So these imaginary lines, which are which can be curves or straight lines are the magnetic field lines. They are also called magnetic lines of force. That how the North Pole will move in the magnetic field or in the effect of this magnetic field. So we can say here that magnetic field is the space around the magnet. It is around the magnet within which magnetic force can be experienced. So this is also one way to define magnetic field. So this is how the magnetic field lines can be drawn. There is one more experiment that we have a bar magnet which is pointed on as north and south poles. And when we place this bar magnet on a white sheet of a paper and we sprinkle the iron filings on it uniformly, then when we sprinkle iron filings on this near the magnet, then what happens? It takes a particular arrangement, the iron filings which we were sprinkling, they take a particular arrangement. Most of the iron material gets deposited on the poles of the magnet. That means the poles are attracting that magnet or that material towards it. And the pattern which were taken by the iron filings were somewhat like this. This we can do experimentally, but now as these are online classes, so we can't show you it experimentally. But this you might have seen many a times. So this is how that iron filing gets arranged when we sprinkle it uniformly near the bar magnet. So what this arrangement tells us, that these dotted lines which I have drawn are actually the magnetic field lines or the imaginary path followed by the North Pole or South Pole, you can say, if it is suspended freely in or when it is kept freely in the magnetic field, because it is having a magnetic field around it. So that magnetic field has caused these iron filings to take a particular arrangement and they are having a particular direction. As from here we know that we are starting from the North Pole and ending up at South Pole. That means these imaginary lines originate from the North Pole. They move around in the magnetic field and they submerge in the material at the South Pole. They do not end up here. They also travel inside the material. But now the magnetic field lines are moving in opposite direction. So we can say that outside the material or outside the magnet, the direction of the magnetic field lines are from north to south, and inside the material the magnetic field lines are moving from south to north. So outside the direction of magnetic field lines is different and inside the magnetic field lines are moving in opposite direction. So we can define magnetic field lines or magnetic lines of force as that magnetic field lines represent the path of an imaginary independent North Pole if it were allowed to move freely in the direction of magnetic field. So it says that when an North Pole is independent and freely moves in the direction of magnetic field, then this gives the path, or the path followed by the North Pole is called magnetic field line. Now let us study the properties of magnetic field lines. So the first property of a magnetic field line is that magnetic field line gives the direction of magnetic field. Or you can say that magnetic field lines are closed continuous curves as they do not end up at the south pole. They originate from the north pole, travel up to the south pole, and then this is the direction of the magnetic field line outside the magnet. And inside the magnet, they travel from south to north. So, magnetic field lines are closed, continuous curves. They do not end up at the poles. The second important property of magnetic field lines is that magnetic field line, they can provide us the direction of the magnetic field. So, when we draw a tangent at any point on the magnetic field line, this tangent gives us the direction of magnetic field at that point. So, let's say if we talk about a point P, that at this point, what is the direction of the magnetic field? Then we have to draw a tangent at this point, and this tangent will give us the direction of force. So, magnetic field is a vector quantity. It is having its magnitude as well as it is having directions. So, this way you can find out the direction of the magnetic field at any point by drawing a tangent at that. So, these arrows are showing up the tangents which are providing the direction of the magnetic field at the respective points. Third important property of magnetic field lines is that magnetic field line do not intersect each other. So that they do not cut each other. Why? So let's say if they cut each other, magnetic field lines of the same magnet or in the same magnetic field. So let's say they are doing so. So we have just now defined that the magnetic field direction at a particular point can be obtained by drawing a tangent on it. So let's say it is point A, and if we want, here we have two magnetic field lines M1 and M2, and if I draw a tangent at a point A with respect to M1 and another tangent at point A at M2 in respect to M2. Now at the same point, two directions of magnetic field are obtained. Is it possible? No. Because it violates our rule that the tangent drawn on the magnetic field lines at any point gives the direction of the magnetic field at that particular point. But how is it possible that at the same point, the magnetic field is in two directions? So this situation that we supposed is not possible. So that is why it is true that magnetic field lines never intersect each other. Then the fourth important property of magnetic field lines is depending upon the strength of the magnetic field. That the degree of closeness or how crowded the magnetic field lines are, it depends on the strength of the magnetic field. So magnetic field lines will be crowded in the region of strong magnetic field. As we have seen near the poles, the magnetic field lines were very much crowded, but they were far away when we talk about at a distance from the bar magnet. So they are crowded in the region of strong magnetic field and they are diverged in the field of weak magnetic field. So this was the topic regarding the properties of magnetic field lines. One important topic other than magnetic field and magnetic field lines is snow rule. What is snow rule? Actually, after the Oersted's experiment, one scientist, Ampere, who discovered electricity, he also experimented on the same topic. and he studied the relative motion of the current in different conductors. And while doing so, he got that when current flows in an electric circuit from south to north in a conductor placed over a magnetic compass, this way, I have shown just the conducting part. Here, we'll be having battery. A switch. So when will the current flow? In which direction? When this key is closed. So this is the closed key symbol. And the current will flow in this direction. So if we mark the directions north, south, east and west. Then and we place the conductor over the magnetic compass. And current is flowing in such a direction that it enters in the conductor from south and exits from the north. Then the magnetic compass deflects towards the west. And when this is done in opposite direction, then it deflects towards the east. But when the current will flow in this direction, so again we'll be having north, south and west and east. So when the direction of the current is reversed, the magnetic compass deflects towards east. So snow rule says, or the word itself, the snow word is telling that according to this rule, when current in a conductor which is placed over the magnetic compass. So when current is flowing from south to north in a conductor placed over the magnetic compass, the magnetic compass deflects towards the west. So this is one way that how magnetic compass is getting deflected when current flows through it. So this is called snow rule. It is also called Ampere's swimming rule. How? Why it is called Ampere's swimming rule? Because Ampere, he also said that it can be assumed that the person swimming and the current flows in such a way that it enters through the feet of the person and exits from the head of the person who is swimming. Then the magnetic field direction will always point towards his left hand. And where his left hand is? Towards the west. So that is why this snow rule is also called Ampere's swimming rule. Now, as we have seen that the shape of magnetic field, that how or what kind of magnetic field is produced, it depends on the shape of the conductor. That what kind of conductor is there in which current is flowing. So accordingly, the magnetic field will be produced. So in this chapter, we'll study different shapes of magnetic fields produced by different shapes of conductor. That we are going to study from the next lecture. In next lecture, we'll study the magnetic field produced due to the current in a straight conductor. So, let us see today's homework. In today's homework, you have 4 questions which are in-text questions of your NCERT at page number 224 and page number 228. So, the first question of your homework is, why does a compass needle get deflected when brought near a bar magnet? Question number 2 is, draw magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. Question number 3 is, list the properties of magnetic field lines. And the last question is that why don't 2 magnetic field lines intersect each other? So this is your homework and the video is getting very long. So we'll discuss the homework solutions, or you can say the pre-text assignment that I've gave you in the assignment 2 of chapter number 12 in a separate video. That you will find along with this video only. So Dear students, you watch this video, hit the like button if you like it and share it with your friends if you find it easy to understand. Till the next video, take care and goodbye.